A new patch is upon us, and this one has 3 new heroes, 10 new units, buffs, and spells. As always, I'll be going over everything and give it a 100% accurate rating. For more update videos and guides, don't forget to subscribe, of course. Okay, let's get started. But before that, let me explain how you obtain these spells in Battlegrounds. So these are actually called Darkmoon prizes and show up every 4 turns in Battlegrounds. So you get a set of spells to choose from on turn 4, 8, 12, and 16. Now that we got that out of the way, let's begin by checking out the hero changes first. Galakrond got removed. F. Finian and Akazamzrak are now back. Akazam got a new secret called Competitive Spirit added to his pool. Still, don't take him. Silas' chances of getting tickets on units after turn 1 got increased. He'll still be pretty far away from tier 1 heroes though. 3 points. Zephyr's got his hero power changed from 4 gold to 3, and I do believe that this will improve him. A big issue is the fact that it was nearly impossible to level and hero power with him in the same turn, but now maybe it's doable. I still have high hopes. 4 points. Betches also got his hero power reduced to 3 gold, but unlike Zephyr's, pirates still suck. 2 points. Now let's dive into the 3 new heroes. Nazoth starts with a 1-1 fish, which is a beast, that gains all the death rattles from your board that died in combat. First of all, you get an extra 1-1 on the board, which isn't nothing. Second of all, this hero just feels like a better Lich King, since it can do multiple death rattles twice instead of just one. Now Lich King is in some cases still better because of board space issues and the targeted death rattles that you need to trigger twice and so on, but having a better coiler on the board for free that can easily get buffed seems good. 5 points for me. K'Thun has a 2 gold hero power, which is already a huge downside. That gives you +1/+1 stats on the board randomly, but it upgrades, so the next time you press it, it will give +2/+2, then +3/+3, and so on. The fact that it's random is also bad, and that it takes a lot of gold before it becomes good is bad. But once it starts giving more than +4/+4 a turn and keeps building up, it does seem insane. So the only way this hero could work is with a strategy where you stay on tier 1, buy divine shield units like protectors, and get strong with probably demons. With a token or salamantle, you can start hero powering from turn 2 on. If this is the case, and I do some math, you'll have +28/+28 stats by turn 8 or 10 gold. This is +4/+4 on every unit, and these are tier 1 and tier 2 units, while others have tier 4 units that are already better statted. In short, this hero seems really bad, but I feel like we are overlooking something, so I'll still give it 3 points. Yashirash is like a weird Yogg. 2 gold to get a random unit from your tavern tier in combat, then get it added to your hand. Upside is that it's great tempo, like Yogg. This doesn't get a 1-1 buff, but guarantees a unit from your tier and saves economy. Downside is that you need board space. Often you'll have a spot you cycle buffs in, so it's okay, but this is not the case for every composition. Also, do you really want to spend 2 gold late game for a random unit that is very likely not going to benefit your specific board? I think the best thing is that you can do some fancy power level turns without losing too much tempo. 3 points. Now for the cards, they added 10 new units, most of them being neutrals, by only taking away 4 existing cards, and 3 of those being neutrals as well. This means that the pool has increased by a bit every game, so the chances of finding a triple are slightly decreased. First unit to go is Righteous Protector. Shit, remember what I said about K'Thun and Protector? Let's scrap that plan. The Beast has also been removed. Also crowd favorite, which I really don't get. It was such a cool unit. And to truly break my heart, Xeris also got lowered into his coffin. F. Now for the new cards, we have Acolyte of K'Thun, which is a 1-star 2-2 taunt with Reborn. Nothing fancy, okay unit, no tribe, so useless to keep around, but a nice tech option in the late game for something like Beasts, or maybe with a Khadgar, so just 2 points. Tormented Ritualist is a 2-3 taunt on tier 2 that gives +1/+1 to adjacent minions whenever it gets attacked. It's a decent tempo play, but because it's a neutral once again, it never sticks around. 3 points. Warden of Old is a 3-3 that has Death Rattle at a coin to your hand. I love a card that literally generates you gold, but do you really want to spend 3 gold on a 3-3 that makes you 1 gold a turn? Or you can just buy a Gambler and make the same money back as this unit would make in 2 turns? Can't wait to see a Warden of Old Baron come though. As Nazoth, there is also some cool potential. And as much as I like this concept because it could enable some nice power level turns, it just seems way too weak since it's again a neutral that can't get buffed. 2 points. Arm of the Empire is a 3-star 4-5 that gives a friendly taunt minion +3 attack whenever it's attacked. Trash, but okay tempo play. 2 points. Big Ferno is a T4 4/4 demon that gets +1/+1 permanently when you summon a demon. This also means during combat, which is a completely new mechanic. This card is huge, maybe even a better watcher. Now Imgang boss might actually get to see some play as the 1/1s will buff this guy. 5 points. This will single-handedly push demons to tier 1 and works pretty well with juggler boards. That's a very bold statement I just made. I definitely won't regret it, sure. Kiraji Heartbringer, something like that, is a 5/5 on tier 4 that gives +2/+2 to adjacent minions whenever a friendly taunt minion dies, so they're really pushing a taunt-based composition. But with neutrals? This one seems pretty bad at first as well, but if you combine this with Arm of the Empires that gives +3 attack, and a couple of Security Rovers or Void Lords, you could have a potential top 4 board. 3 points. Champion of... is Goldgrubber's little cousin. He gets +1/+1 permanent stats during combat phase when a friendly taunt is attacked. So it's better than Grubber because it doesn't require goldens, just taunts. If you have multiple taunts that value trade, it can go out of control. Again, think about Security Rover or Void Lords. Huge downside is that it doesn't have a tribe, so it can't be buffed by anything else. Not even Lightfang from Menagerie, while a Grubber, a Hangry Dragon, or other comparable units can. But again, it fits this taunt archetype they're pushing. It's close, but I'll give it a 4 just to be safe. Faceless Tavern Goer is a 5-star 4/4, which reads, choose a minion and Bob's Tavern and transform into a plain copy of it. This seems horrible unless you roll it in the same tavern with a Nomi or Kaligos or want to pair game something specific. Could also hoard this in hand, but seems very risky. Maybe just a good unit with Milhouse and Maiev. It just makes tier 5 pool worse. 1 point. Mitrax the Unraveler is a 4/4 on tier 5 that gets +1/+1 at the end of the turn for every minion type you control. It's a better Razor for Menagerie. Major downside is that it doesn't have a tribe itself, but when you get this unit early, the stats should make up for that. 4 points. And then we have Elistra the Immortal, a tier 6 7/7 with Divine Shield and Reborn. Whenever a friendly taunt is attacked, this gets attacked instead. But why? Even if you get a full taunt comp, this seems pretty useless. It has small synergy with the champion and could even be teched in some cases, like when you taunt Goldrin with Beast but want Makasa to go off first, or when you want to play around Cleave, but still. I guess it still has pretty insane stats though. That actually takes it up to 2 points. Now the spells. Let's get started with what you get offered on turn 4 or 6 gold. Give a minion +2/+2. 2 points, not too impactful. Add 2 gold coins to your hand, 4 points, as this makes for an interesting leveling curve. Spend it here on turn 4, level, and you can buy another unit, basically becoming an Omu for a turn. Give your minions +1/+1. I'll give it 4 stars because you can hold on to this until you have a full board. Discover a minion from Tavern Tier 1 is generally pretty bad, unless you're going for demons or looking for a triple on Tier 1. Give minions in Bob's Tavern +1 health for the rest of the game, can get 4 points from me. It's not insane, but just better than some of the other rewards in the long run. Your next 3 rolls cost 0 gold, isn't that bad, but also not that good. 2 points. Add a minion to Bob's Tavern for the rest of the game is once again a game-lasting effect and probably the best out of all these spells. 5 points. Now for turn 8, which is 10 gold, discover a unit from your tavern tier. Just make sure you're level to tier 5 or 6 here. 3 points. Give a minion at the end of each round +2/+2. It's like a baby Ragnaros hero power. 4 points. Replace all minions in the tavern with minions from a higher tavern tier seems only good if you have a bunch of 4 or 5 stars in there. But since you can't cast this whenever, I'll give it 4 points. Also, do we remember how bad Lady Vash was? Then there's one where at the end of every turn it will discount leveling by 2 gold. By 10 gold you're often already on tier 5, so it's only good if you want to go to tier 6 at some point. 2 points. Discover a minion from your last opponent is okay, because again you can hold this as long as you want, but it's slower than the other spells though, so 3 points. Your Battlegrounds trigger twice this turn is in case you don't have a Bren yet, I guess. 2 points, it'll just give you some good tempo. I mean, maybe we could do like Khadgar transitions with this actually. Gain 1 gold this turn only, but repeat this every turn. Pretty sweet if you already got your direction. 4 points. Give a minion +5/+5 and taunt seems really bad compared to the other stuff, unless you are dying. 2 points. Let's look at the spells on turn 12, this is already very late game. Give a minion Divine Shield, so George. Still 3 points. Then we have Ice Block, you only take this if you know you'll lose the next fight. 2 points. Double a minion's attack is actually insane with Deflecto, Cleave and so on. 5 points. Fill your hand with bananas is +10/+10 basically, like having a Light Fang for one turn. 2 points. Discover a new hero power is only good for heroes like Omu or Elise, and even then it has really a small impact. Unless you hurdle something really good, like for example Reno, but that's not very likely. 1 point. Return a friendly non-golden minion to your hand and give it +2/+2. So, Jendis? Just Amagedon and Battlemaster? 1 point. Make a random minion in Bob's Tavern golden is super RNG and mainly good for the discover. You could, I guess, spend a lot of gold to buy the entire tavern and then you can choose which minion you make golden, but that's such a commitment. I'll give it 2 points because you're better off just taking the next spell then. Discover a minion from tier 6, which gets 3 points. Not much to say. For some reason, we also have spells for turn 16, which is crazy as games rarely even get this far. But let's rate them anyway. For the rest of the game, units cost 1 less, so for like 1 turn probably. 1 point. Your first 5 refreshes every turn cost 0 is actually pretty good if you're looking for specific deck cards or key units. 3 points. Make a friendly minion golden and return it to your hand is pretty busted compared to these other spells. 5 points. Refresh your gold, isn't this just strictly better than the 5 free refreshes? Cause it's a one-time use, but it's turn 16. 4 points. Then we get a 6-star unit that gets stats equal to your biggest guy on the board. It was pretty nice with Bran. Okay, 4 points then. Discover a Darkmoon prize from each of the previous prize turns is actually decent, I think. 4 points. Give a friendly minion +10/+10, Divine Shield, and Wind Free. It's a Lakir but better because it doesn't get taunt. Slap this on a Cleave or a Macaw or a Poison and win the game. 5 points. And that was pretty much it. There was a lot to unpack here. Do you disagree with some of the things I said, or do you have your own theories? Then please leave them down below again. And don't forget to subscribe for more high quality Battlegrounds content. Also, a like goes a long way, so that would be much appreciated. Thanks for watching and good luck on the Battlegrounds.